the time. We were taking everything we possibly could, but nothing really.
Good afternoon, everybody. We're going live in just 30 seconds here. Super excited. Great show today. We have Juan and Jorge and Cody, and we're going to also have Vera Earl. You're John?
Yeah. Juan, Jorge, John.
I don't get it. Anyways, Cody will explain his logic to us later. All right, there we go.
The guy with the
J's. So let's get that intro going. To the A, to the S T E, Y, put your T, to the E, to the L I C I O, to the D, to the E, to the
taste. I can hear myself.
Okay. Good. You can turn it up or down right
here.
There you go. Tasty Show with fresh cuts by your host, Wesley Soares.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. I got love in my tummy and I feel like I'm loving you.
Welcome to the Tucson Tasty Show. I'm your host, Wesley Soares, and we have an amazing show lined up for you today. Some amazing special guests here in studio. We're going to get to hear from Vera Earl Premium Beef and hear what they're doing out at the ranch. We also have Cody Peck of Network Outdoors, or your financial advisor guy, Cody Peck.
One or the other.
Okay, fair enough.
Network Outdoors today.
And always you got to go check us out because you got to be able to see the food, right? Not just hear about how amazing it is. So go to the Tucson Tasty Show on Facebook, or even the let's see, that's the YouTube,
and it's Tucson the Tasty Show 520.
The Tasty Show 520.
Yeah.
The Tasty Show 520. Outstanding. So we have, we wouldn't be the Tucson Tasty Show without our amazing guests, our guest and sponsors. Thank you, Kiki Rogers of Country Financial Insurance, Vero Premium Beef, Nova's Vita, Mafia Kitchen, Financial Advisor Cody Peck, Network Outdoors, Local First Arizona, Levity Wellness Center, Sirius Visual. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you want to be a part of the show, that would be great. If you come into, or if you call 520-790-2040, that's 520-790-2040. You can ask us any questions you want related to food. So,
dangerous poppages in there.
Fair enough. And we have an amazing guest chef today. The chef is, let's see. Juan of
Juan Almamza.
We have too many people in the studio today, I think. We have Juan of El Taco Rustico. Did I say that right?
Yes.
Perfect. And we're going to talk to him about tacos and some media and some goat, I think.
We got goat?
Yeah, he's got goats.
So he's the goat?
But he'll tell us about that. So we just had Vera Earl show up. A little bit late, but that's okay. We're happy to have you here. What's up?
Not much. How are you?
Good. Good to see you.
Good seeing you.
And go ahead and introduce yourself.
I'm Andrew Hooper. I'm the inventory and logistics manager for Bear Earl Premium Beef.
And the when you do order the VE or at vepremiumbeef.com, is it your face that shows up at their door to drop it off?
No.
Oh, darn.
Somebody's better. We got better looking people than me to do that.
Oh, fair enough. All right. Well, all right. But you do deliver directly to their doors for anybody from Oro Valley all the way down to Vail, correct?
Even a two-back. We've been going down a two-back.
All right. So that's a long drive from Snoida.
Every Thursday. So far, we're working on it. All right. But yeah, every Thursday we're delivering.
So is it bovine power or is it horsepower that you're using to get it out to the
Dodge powers?
Fair enough. And Jorge.
Yes, sir.
Good to see you. Thank you so much for coming in and helping us out with the broadcast today. Sure. And making sure that we can we can speak to everybody.
Indeed. Yeah, definitely.
Hey, go ahead and introduce yourself and tell everybody who you are and what you do.
Sure. So Jorge Ruiz, I work with Interfaith Community Services. I do outreach, but I'm also out in the networking scene, and I'm really kind of a big fan of the Tasty Show.
Well, thank you.
The Tucson Tasty Show.
The Tucson.
Because I happen to like food, man. You know, and Tucson has quite a bit of good places for that. And I love the food and the mixture of culture within the food. So I think we all meet there, and it's,
absolutely,
it's beautiful. You know, it's the local water hole, man. Everybody goes there. So I wanted to be here. And obviously, I don't think Juan's going to need me. I heard him speaking English already.
Yes.
But,
thank you.
You know, I might just sit here silently this time. But we shall see.
And thank you so much for the support. We really appreciate you.
I have a sponsor for you, actually. The guys from Hercore.
Yeah.
I told them I was going to be here. And, you know, we want to showcase, obviously, the Hispanic, the Mexican restaurants. And Luis really liked the idea. So he might.
Well, you know, Luis's father was a butcher, and they grew up over butchery.
Oh, yeah. He's got three pictures of the carniceria there at his office. So,
yeah, we were talking. I was talking with him. He wants to get his dad in. We're talking about doing something with Tucson Tasty people in Tucson that.
I need as much help as possible with that. I think that would be great.
It's going to happen, man.
Or I could go in and hang out with Vera Earl, or we could just get, you know, go and pick up a cow from Vera Earl and then take it over there to do the butchering.
I'll show up after when you guys, you know, cook the tacos.
So. And I know somebody that can cook some killer beef.
Oh, man.
And some amazing
stuff.
This
is turning into like a boy band. A cooking boy band.
So, and you make some amazing bedia. In fact, I would say that he's probably the reason that bedia is on the menu at every restaurant in Tucson now.
That's awesome.
Yeah, when I started, not too many people do make bedia. Right now, everybody would.
They have to. I mean, they have to keep up with you. And you make, and we're going to get to dive into that a little bit more, you know, after the first break. But you make over 100,000 tacos a year.
Whew.
Wow.
Probably more.
Probably more now, right?
Wow. Yeah, I cook 250 pounds of birria every 3 days, and then
that's beautiful. What cuts of beef are you using?
I use chuck now, and I have a goat and lamb in my menu.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody wants a lamb birria. We just mix the meat with the beef broth,
right?
And it tastes delicious.
Was the birria originally? Wasn't it goat? Back in the South Mexico.
Actually, the Spain. Mm-hmm. Spanish people call birria this stew they make, and basically they make it with goat.
Yeah,
but they don't like the goat. The Spanish people, when they come to America, they really don't like the flavor, so they try to cover it with a lot of spices,
mm-hmm.
chiles, and flavors to mm-hmm. cover the flavor of the goat meat.
Yeah,
and they call birria. You look in Google what the birria means, you're going to know why.
Mm.
There's something, no, the name exactly means something not very, very agradable. It's not very pleasurable. You know?
Yeah, yeah. It basically is saying that it's not a real, kind of a strong taste. It's not easy, you know, to taste, I guess. So that's what mm-hmm. birria. Even the word sounds a little aggressive, doesn't it?
No, you look in Google. That means something like not really good.
Yeah, and it's interesting because now it's become, if you hear birria, your mouth waters.
Oh, no. Mexico, people eat birria for years.
I've been having that for years. Yeah.
That's actually really cool. So what would you have for a trick for an at-home cook in the kitchen to help with doing something, a pressure cooker, a pan? What kind of a tip do you have for all the listeners at home?
Well, usually you have to share the meat,
mm-hmm.
and then boil it with all this, you call adobo,
mm-hmm.
it's a birria adobo. You have to marinate overnight. Then it's a long process for cook the birria. So
marinate it overnight and really let those all the flavors kind of combine and meld together. Okay,
and then develop. One of the basics is use vinegar in the adobo.
Vinegar.
Vinegar
in the adobo. So that actually would break down and kind of brine the meat, wouldn't mm-hmm. it? So it breaks down those protein chains. Exactly. So it keeps the moisture and everything in the meat.
Exactly. And then when I started birria, usually I start with the basic recipe.
Mm-hmm.
Then in the first year, I went at my restaurant, I start adding more stuff, more spices, different.
And over 30 ingredients now, right? From what I understand.
Wow.
That's quite
so good. Well-developed, like well-rounded birria, and we can't wait to try some of that.
Oh, he brought some?
Yeah, it's for the Tasty Bites.
In the plot
in the third section.
Now, is this beef or does this have some lamb in it?
I only use beef.
Only beef on this.
Yeah, I don't like it. I'm kind of half Spanish. And
he looked me up online and he saw a white boy from Tucson. So he was like, we're going to do beef.
Yeah, because people here in the north side of Mexico and then actually in the border, Nogales, the birria. Cars, birria street cars.
Right.
They use beef lips.
Mm.
That's all they use for the birria, and the flavor is really good.
Mm. Yeah, so you can use any. I'm making out with the cows all the time. No.
Yeah, they don't use.
I'm trying to find a good joke for it, and I've got no good jokes. So I'm going to leave it alone. We're going to let that
you
one.
You can lie. Just kind of the kiss of greatness.
The kiss of greatness. All right, there we go. From the
yeah. And is the flavor really different? It's pretty close to the texture of the birria. Is it different
with the beef lips?
With the, yeah,
it's different.
Mm. So it's probably softer, huh?
Mm, it can be softer, but yeah. But the flavor is stronger for the like a beef steak and lips is completely different.
That's interesting. Yeah. Wow, that's interesting.
And it's actually one of the things that we talk about when we're talking about Beer Earl and when we're promoting them out at the restaurants for the TV show and stuff. It's beef that tastes like beef. And one of the reasons why Beer Earl is one of my favorites is because they dry age the beef for 21 days. So it actually allows, you know, that.
So the muscles relax and get tender. I love that.
And this is very great. Good. This is behind the scenes here, Cody.
Wow. It is. Behind the scenes awesome. Here.
So I just eat stuff. I don't know how it's happening. You know, so I'm that's pretty awesome.
That's usually me in this corner. Just so you know,
he's trying to absorb it and trying to come up with a smart aleck remark for us to throw us off. But we'll get there eventually. Well, I'm Wesley Source. We're going to go into our first break here of the Tucson Tasty Show. We'll be right back with more from. Juan and everybody here, thank you for being here today. And we're going to talk a little bit more about your history, how you got started, and kind of the Phoenix story that you have, because from the ashes of COVID, you really rose. And I can't wait to talk more about that. Thank you to our amazing sponsors and our guests today. Kiki Rogers, Country Financial Insurance, Veral Premium Beef, Novus Vita, Mafia Kitchen, your financial guy, Cody Peck, Network Outdoors, Local First Arizona, Levity Wellness Center, and Cirrus Visual. I'm your host, Wesley Source. Stay tasty, Tucson.
Tired of that neck or back pain? Feeling overwhelmed and anxious?
Kind of a behind the scenes, if everybody's on YouTube, Tasty Show 520, don't forget to subscribe. Hit that subscribe button now and support us. And I have a question. Do you like spicy food?
I love spicy food. I can handle it very much.
So you can't handle it very much? Well, we have a really special sticker that we do for people that... They're right here?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Towards the end, we'll have you, if you want to earn the special sticker, and everybody, Jorge, if you want to jump in on this, you're more than welcome.
What are we talking about here, man?
We're talking about chips.
Is that why I signed that paper? I might just die today.
This is the Last Dab Extreme, and this is the Tucson Tasty Show Challenge, and you just need a little bit, but we're gonna do it in the last segment, and tell us what you think of this, because this is some of my favorite hot sauce. It's a really good developed flavor, but it's Pepper X, which is the hottest pepper in the world. 3 million Scoville. But it doesn't really get that far. So after we taste your amazing food, we'll burn out the rest of your taste buds.
I don't know.
We'll see.
Let's see what happens, man. How are you?
Don't worry, we've only had three people go in the party after this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
not too bad.
And we're going back in.
Now back to the Tucson Tasty Show with your host, Wesley Soares, on 1030 The Voice.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. I got love in my tummy and I feel like I'm loving you.
Welcome back to the Tucson Tasty Show. I'm your host, Wesley Soares, and we are here with some amazing guests. And thank you, everybody, for being here. We've got Juan of El Taco Rustico. And I had to say that about 500,000 times before the show to make sure I said it right, even though I'm a Tucson guy. And then we also have Jorge Ruiz of...
Just... Jorge Ruiz today.
Yes. The man and the myth, the legend today.
The foodie.
And we have Vera Earl in the corner with Cody Peck. Andrew with Vera Earl, premium beef. And I'm writing that down because...
yeah, he is in my corner. We're preparing for our debut in the boxing world.
Okay, Cody. Yes.
There you go.
We're not going to film that one, but we will take bets at... No. just kidding. So we have... So Juan of El Taco Rustico, we were talking about before the break, how you got started during COVID with your brick and mortar. Now, before that, you were in the swap meets at the Totem swap meet.
Exactly.
And you're actually from Mexico originally.
Torreón, Coahuila, Mexico.
Beautiful. And beautiful area. And you grew up going to... the swap meets and making tacos with your mom?
Yeah. Actually, my mom always selling stuff in the swap meets. She come to the United States and bring stuff to sell in the swap meets.
Mm-hmm.
And she always needed my help to loading and moving the stuff. So I decided to start my business really young. Actually, my brother started this little grilled chicken, like the pollo feliz chicken.
Mm-hmm.
And my brother don't keep it for too long. So I just take the idea and I start grilling chicken when I was like 11, 12 years old. And that works. I make some money sometimes. And my first job in Mexico was when I was like 16, mm-hmm. at this steak house.
Right.
So when I come to the guy with the owner of the steak house, always like, I mean, I know I cook everything supposed to. And I asked for the job and he said, You know how to cook chickens? And I said, yeah, I grill chicken all the time and that's what makes them. Coming in, he gave me a test. And I said, no, you don't know anything.
All right.
And I said, okay, I can try it. And say, you really want to know, you wanna learn, I teach you everything you wanna learn.
Wow.
So that was an old guy, old man, like 55 years old. And he's telling me, you just come every day, take your time, mm-hmm. but I don't want to pay you until you learn. I get another test and pass the test.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes me 2 weeks to learn all the steaks, the ribeye, the bone, all the temperatures and everything. Then when I told him I'm ready, he gave me another test and I pass. And
it's that old saying, man, when the student is ready, the teacher shows up. So it happened for him. That's awesome.
Then from then, I quit 2 months later. The guy got so mad at me.
Hmm.
I never forget how mad he got. And he told me, that's one thing you have to learn, too. You cannot quit just like that. But I was young. I was 16 years old.
Right.
I always ready to learn more. So since then, I probably work in like 30 restaurants in Torreón.
Right. You actually worked at a couple different premier kitchens here in Tucson.
When I got here to Tucson, I was like 23 years old and I had a lot of experience.
Mm-hmm.
When I stopped in Nogales in my way, well, I never thinking came to America. I love Mexico. I always make my money in Mexico easy. So I came to Nogales because I got a little family thing in home, so I have to leave my home. And I come with a friend in Nogales. And first day, I see a sign of the hiring cooks.
Mm-hmm.
And I stop at the cafeteria, the cafeteria Lourdes. Mm-hmm. Still there, I think so. And there was a lady, the manager, and I asked him for the job, for the position. And she told me, you know how to cook? I say, yes. And then she said, how long you been here? No, Alice, I just got here yesterday. And she said, oh, I'm sorry, we don't hire people who don't live in Nogales for more than 6 months. I was like, okay, what do you want me to do? If every restaurant does the same, what are you going to do for 6 months? I'm going to live in the arroyo, in the river, or the homeless for 6 months? And she just watching me like that. Come back to work tomorrow. So I got the position the same day.
That's good.
Wonderful. And then you worked at a couple other places. When she got up to Tucson, you worked at Hacienda del Sol.
Since the first time I got to Tucson, I worked for my first job in Green Valley with Ramon Bon, the owner of the Merendero. Mm-hmm. He gave me the work right away. So I worked for him for like 12 years.
El Merendero, right there on 12th Avenue?
In Green Valley, in Los Amigos restaurant. That's my first time.
Okay.
And then I moved to the Merendero for like another six years.
Okay.
And then after there, for some reason, I go to find a friend at Tucson Country Club, and I see the chef walking out. I don't speak in English at all. And I ask him, do you have a job here? He say, you cook? I say, yeah, I know how to cook. So they hire me. I was making like $8 in the Merendero in those times. And then when they hired me at the Tucson Country Club, they offered me $14.
Wow.
Almost 20 years
ago. Oh, wow.
And this guy was destined to cook.
Yes.
Because there was doors just opening for him everywhere he went. It's pretty amazing. I worked
for Tucson Country Club, Wire Creeks, Communities, Hacienda del Sol. I've been a chef in his bistro in Oro Valley. That used to be the owner of Cici's Pizza Bar, this place, and I worked for him for a couple of years.
Wow. And then what changed to make you decide that you wanted to have a food truck making tacos at the Toro Odom swap meet?
So I mean, no money at all. And actually, when I was at the Tucson Country Club for 12 years, my wife and me, we making very good money. And we tried to get our first food truck. But that was in like 2007, 2006, when the economy dropped really bad, so we lost all the money, all the savings, and then we got back to start again. And then
I want to add a little anecdote, man. You'll love this. So I used to work at the swap meet, the Palo Verde, the Tanker Verde swap meet. You may be familiar with it. And it was booming. When I was there, I was collector. I collected rent for the spaces that were there. And everything was great, but the food just was not. And they never really had, they had the cafeteria, they had a couple of grill burgers and things like that.
Right.
But there was an explosion of food happening at the Tohono O'odham. I mean, you would go there for a variety. It was like, he was right in the middle of that.
That take me like 2 years to get a permit to get my stand at the Tohono. Mm-hmm. Because they have like 45, 60 food stands.
I know, right.
Mm-hmm. And they don't want more. I mean, they have it, the insurance don't let the Tohono keep a lot of more food. So when I get the permit to sell American breakfast because nobody sells American breakfast, and then they don't want to give you another permit for sell Mexican food.
So American breakfast, that was like pancakes?
Pancakes, eggs. Okay. And then I tried to make the turkey legs, the smoked turkey legs.
Those,
and then one day I'm catering a party. I catered a party for tacos because I had my chef pay for make food. So I have some leftovers, tripas, carne asada, and pastor. And I just brought it to the swami, to my little stand with a little crew. The first day, I got it back. All people come to try my tacos. And I just right away say, what the fuck I'm doing selling breakfast? I can sell tacos here like crazy.
Pancakes.
So next day, I doubled the size of everything. And I sold, like in 2 hours, I sold out.
That's awesome.
Wow, so next week, I brought it double everything, and I got sold out. And in 5 months, I was start selling 1,000 tacos in one morning.
Yep. Wow.
And I never quit the tacos. Since the first day, I see how people can eat that tacos right there. I said, this is going to be my...
Yeah.
My
that was big. It brought people to the Tohono O'odham. They really could sell the food.
Right.
It was a place to sell your stuff, trade your stuff, but it was the food that was taking people to the place.
A lot of people miss that place. It's still closed since the COVID. So when the COVID started, I get my a little man extra money because I was start doing the Tucson Meet Yourself in October, and that was very very good season for me. All the time doing really good, and then when I used to live in behind my restaurant in the little parking lot,
right?
And one day I passed and I saw the sign for lease, and I just turn around, call, get the phone, and call the guys. Hey, I want to do something with this. And that was a broker, and say, okay, let me talk to the owner. We can do business, blah blah blah. So they selling everything for $25,000, and I only have $25,000 for all the things I mean, that was my money. Wow, okay. That's all I have. So I negotiate everything. I only buy $5,000 to the owner of the restaurant. And I told him if he can, I can use his equipment for the first 2 months. Until I move something, I used to have a little always equipment. He said, okay. So when the COVID started, I leased the place in February. And March, the COVID started.
Right. Yeah. And we're going to talk about that a little bit more when we come back from the break, because we have a hard break at the bottom of the hour here. And then we're going to also have a Tasty Bites with Juan. Looking forward to that because I saw some of those and my mouth is watering just thinking about it. But thank you to our amazing sponsors. That's Kiki Rogers Country Financial Insurance, Beer Rural Premium Beef, Mafia Kitchen, Financial Guy Cody Peck, Network Outdoors, Local First Arizona, Levity Wellness Center, and Cirrus Visual. And if you're on the YouTube channel, Cirrus Visual actually printed out this really cool banner for me. They did an amazing job upscaling all the logos and making sure that it looked right. And they actually played with the logos going back and forth a lot. But I'm Wesley Source. Stay tasty, Tucson.
I'm a bear legal.
This is a Bloomberg Money Minute. Boeing is on the clock now with less than 3 weeks to convince the Justice Department not to prosecute the company on criminal charges after the government found the plane maker breached a 3-year-old deal to protect it from charges stemming from the
It's about a 3-minute break. If you want to grab the tacos.
Okay.
Amazing story.
Did you see science?
You're doing this whether you want to or not, because Sonora said that you volunteered. So just so you know.
Doing what?
You're doing the Tucson Tasty Show Challenge.
How are you with
this woman? Going to kill me.
Yeah. After we start trying and talking about the food and stuff, offer up the beef for Viral. And we don't need any of that back. That's all his. Yeah. Good. I just like listening to his story.
It's an amazing
story.
It's incredible.
I don't even have to do anything today. I like these days when it's a little bit more laid back and it's just getting the story and the content.
The story is, that's why, you know, Wendy, when you speak to her, her story is crazy. Güero Canelo's story, oh Lord, it's insane.
Yes.
Who's the other person?
Is he better now?
Oh, yeah, man, he's good. Yeah. I've come out with him a couple of times. He's doing fine.
Good.
He almost died, though.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
So he, on his way out, he fell, broke 8 ribs, and punctured his lung. And as he was healing from all that, on his way out, literally, he got pneumonia. Now he was kind of in a very precarious place. And
especially with your lung.
Yeah, but he's a fighter, man. I mean, God willing, when we get him out, you know, he openly talked to, I have a little podcast myself, and he openly talked about how when he was coming up, when his mom was pregnant with him, somehow she attempted 3 times to abort him.
Thank you. Explanation point.
And it didn't happen. And so,
90 seconds.
You know, if I found out I was trying, I'd be pretty brokenhearted, right?
Yeah.
Well, Güero, he took it the other way, man. He thought, I was meant to be here. They can't stop me. So he carries that. He was homeless when he was 8 and, you know, trying to build Güero Canelo.
60 seconds.
This dude is like, if they try to abort me 3 times, if that didn't work, that means, so he's still here. He's doing all right.
Yeah, smell it. I can smell it. But he uses Chuck.
I nailed it. That was great. I'm excited. Vera Earl.
I'm excited to see him.
He was talking about, or they were talking about trying to get him some tongue and stuff. Oh, yeah. No, I don't tell anybody that. If they don't listen to the show.
He didn't do a tasty bite. He brought a tasty platter.
Oh, my gosh. Look at that.
This is out of control, man.
He's got napkins.
My man.
9 yards.
I got to take my picture and send it to the people.
To make them drool?
Yes.
All right.
By the people, I mean
when I come in here in about 15 seconds, I think. Let's see what happens.
Let's see what happens.
Back to the Tucson Tasty Show with your host, Wesley Source, on 1030 The Voice.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. I got love in my tummy, and I feel like I'm loving you.
Welcome back to the Tucson Tasty Show. I'm your host, Wesley Source, and we're having a great conversation here in studio with Juan of El Taco Rustico and a local legend when it comes to tacos. I mean, it's just thank you so much for being here on the show today.
Happy to be here.
And what an amazing story. And
truly an amazing story.
It really is.
You didn't just bring in a tasty bite for us. Yes. Yeah. You didn't just bring in a tasty bite for us. I mean, I think everybody is shut down in the studio and walking in to have some amazing, because it just smells incredible. Now, before we get to tasty bites, which is my favorite segment, by the way, because we get to try some amazing, or something that represents you as a chef. I wanted to finish up a little bit of the story of what or how you started. So, when we left, or when we went on break, we were talking about how you had just opened and you signed your lease in February and of 2020, and this is right before everything started shutting down. So, that was in February. What happened in March? Because the city shut down in March.
So the owner of the restaurant, my landlord, told me, "You want to break the lease? This thing's coming bad. Everything's gonna be so crazy." And I told him, "Nope. I'm going to keep it doing it." I say, "Are you sure?" "Yes." I say, "Okay, it's all yours." And March 19, I have everything ready to open the swap meet on Friday. They shut down everything on Friday 19.
Oh, wow. March.
And then I decide go to the swap meet. Everybody say they're going to keep selling food because they have no rules, the city rules, to close when they want. But yeah, they should have the swap meet too. So right. I just told my wife, you know, let's go to the restaurant, open it. Because we don't have a plan to open it until like April. Paint the restaurant, fix it a little bit. But we have everything, all the food ready to go to the swap meet. So we don't want to just throw away the food.
Mm.
And we come to the swap meet,
right.
To the restaurant, my wife and me, just both open the doors and start.
Wow. So you guys,
we don't have a sign yet. We don't have the POS system yet ready.
You didn't have the POS or the point of sale system. You didn't have a sign. You had a sign painted. And from what I understand, the chef community really came in to help you out.
I have to say thank you all the time when I talk about this. I always thank my chef family. Wonderful. They love me. I love everyone. I know like 35 chefs here in Tucson.
That's wonderful.
Yeah. This Matt Gable introduced me to the Gut Astronomy Union in Tucson. And from then, people call me to go to the Tucson City Gastronomy. They call me to go to everything talking about food. I have to be there.
Destined, my friend. Destined.
Yes. And we opened the restaurant in Cinco de Mayo.
Yes.
We do the best big sell in the Rustico. And after that, we never sell less of the money we sold that day. Never.
Oh my. Well, so
we saw almost that probably from right now, yes, the quesadillas, I probably already sell like a 600,000.
Oh my.
Yes, for the quesadillas. Because I can check in the PO system since I open. I check like every year and it's a lot of tacos.
It's a lot of tacos.
A question.
Sure.
Really quickly. What was your driving force? I mean, obviously you saw all the signs. There was a journey for you. It's now you're telling us, and I know it seems kind of easy, right? But it wasn't.
No, it wasn't. Okay.
So what was your driving force as you did this? What kept you going? Even in COVID, you said, you know what? This is not going to stop me. What was that?
My mom was like that. My mom always really were. She would do, well, we are seven in the family.
Mm-hmm.
And my dad was like a worker. He was a welder. He don't make that much money for it. And then since my mom decided to keep in charge of the family, she always pushes to do the best. Never.
Son chambeadores.
Yeah. She never say, I'm tired. She never say, I cannot do this. She never say. Always she say, we just make what we have to make. So my dad always told my mom, just take it off to the school and put all the kids to work. And my mom said, nope, they have to be something. They have to do something.
That's wonderful.
We are poor. We're coming from a really poor family. So at the end, two brothers doctors, one engineer, another is a nurse. I don't get the school because when I want to go to the chef school, my mom said, that career is not for men. That's for... She tried to mean that's for...
Mm-hmm.
You know, for gay people, something like that. That's what she told. And I say, nope, I want to be chef.
Crazy
you don't
people
want it,
is what it
you
is.
Want it, yeah, you it want is yeah. And I was 16 when I told her, I'm going to be a chef. My life, I'm going
to
be a chef.
And, so and you always are. Just had that vision to do it.
Yeah,
so,
and I always try. I'm always
do it. Let's talk about the food that you brought in that brings so many people in and causes you to make more than 100,000 tacos a year. That's a lot of tacos. So let's talk about the, go ahead and tell us what you brought.
Well, I brought the quesadillas. It's one thing, for being honest, I don't like cheese with birria.
Okay.
So I never thought I'm going to make quesadillas at my restaurant. I have this friend, it's Michael Lopez. It's a DJ. I don't know if you know this guy.
Who is it?
Michael Lopez.
Yeah. Yeah, we do know him.
So
yeah.
He came to my restaurant in the first month and he told me, make a quesadilla for me and I'm going to post it in my media.
Mm-hmm.
And I make it. So he make me a quesadilla at the restaurant.
And with cheese on it.
With cheese. I do birria.
This is so cool. So with the you put a little cheese on it, so you get a little crunch on the outside of the taco.
I saw some pictures in the internet about the tortilla getting crispy outside, but the tortillas here in America is really hard to make it like looks like you burn it.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to put cheese in the bottom to make it look
a little crispy.
Yeah, okay.
I'm going to take this bowl out. This so tell us about this bowl. What's going on with this bowl?
So it's the same as birria. We have birria stew and birria tacos. And we do quesabirrias. And we use birria for like tortas, burritos.
There's birria shakes, birria ice cream. You got the whole thing.
Yeah, I was talking to her about today. Everybody wants birria at the restaurant. I'm probably going to sold out my 250 pounds today, the ones I make last night.
Oh, my gosh. And so as we're passing the tacos around, so
do we just dive right in there and get some?
Get some. This is what we're doing. And,
that's awesome. All right. Well,
so this is beef. The cuts of beef that you're using is the chuck, right? I know somebody that does amazing chuck roasts, and I think we'll let him take over for a second while we're talking. So tell us about what you brought in for Juan.
We actually brought you a prime graded chuck roast.
Wow.
For you to try and got some of our information in it, but you know, 21 day dry aged.
Mm.
Have it here for you. So take it home, take it to the restaurant, try it out. And hopefully we can strike a deal and get our beef into your restaurant.
Definitely. Thank you very much. This is amazing.
You're welcome.
So this is grown, the ranch is in Sonora.
Yeah.
And it's...
Wow.
Sonora from Sonora.
Right. Well, but the... she's not here today, but they are...
So all of our cows are...
Sustainable.
Bred, born, and raised... on our ranches in Sonora. We have 210,000 acres of pastures.
Wow.
2,900 mother cows. And we raise
amazing.
Everything there. There's no antibiotics, no hormones. It is, I've had some good beef, but I've never had beef like this before. I won't eat anything else.
I see a big party, a big food party happening at your ranch.
Yeah.
where
we need to.
It's happening today. They actually rent it out for weddings and stuff. They had a wedding there today.
So I'm thinking a big tasty show. Palooza.
I can't, I can neither confirm nor deny in the works.
That's going to be awesome.
Yeah. But so I just had a bite of this Bedia and or this Bedia taco. Cody, I don't know why you're not diving into this, man. I passed it right to you.
Put it over here and then it went that way.
It went that way. Well,
so the second, I decide like a the first year, I decided to make the rojito de camarón. It's a shrimp taco, but made the same way to the quesadilla and the mahi-mahi.
So is this all gluten-free, just yes. As a dietary question?
All my food is gluten-free unless you use flour tortilla.
It's, so there's no cross-contamination, and then... Nope. Wow.
Yes, that's with tortilla. Yes, with tortilla.
So that's just like Charo, the El Charo restaurants. They are very, they keep everything very segregated and very very clean, so that if any dietary needs are needed, mm-hmm. you can come into those restaurants and not have to worry about it. And I'm going in for the soup.
So crunchy, man.
This bowl of amazing. Look at this. I know, right? Mm. And you made that. It was probably at least an hour or hour ago, hour and a half ago that you made that. And it's got that crunch. It's
yeah,
got
I'm,
that.
I'm making it.
I like the cinnamon, the garlic, the onion. It's all just so incredible.
It crunches all the way to the end. This is awesome.
And amazing. Where are you guys? Where's your new restaurant? Because now you've won the hearts of Tucson, and everybody is not only loyal, but you have your following. And I mean, you've got to have your regulars that come in all the time to make 100,000 tacos or more a year. So you opened up a second restaurant.
Yes,
huh? Tell us where that new one.
Well, last year, actually, this location. I want this rent this location since like probably when I started in the Swami. This is there used to be Mr. K's Barbecue and 29 Park in 29, right behind the UPS.
Mm-hmm.
And Mr. K's was a good. He always go to the Swami to work in the mornings, and all the time I ask him for list me the location. So, but he have some renters for almost 10 years. So last year, he decided to let the people go, and he called me if I want to lease the place. He know I have it already my restaurant, really successful. And he said, you want to open in my place? And I said, well, probably. Depends how the rent is going to be. So we make a good negotiation with the building. It takes me 1 year to fix everything, but I leave the place beautiful. This building is old. Mm. We have to replace almost everything. New gas lines, new walls. So, but yeah, it's now open. We opened in March. It's already 3 months. And it looks like the same thing happened with the old place. We opened for 3 months already, and it's exactly the same sales I do for in the old place in the first 3 months.
That's amazing.
Beautiful. So
the salsa is really good too, by the way. The red salsa.
We're going to ask mm-hmm. more about if you're making what you're making in house and what you're getting from local suppliers after this break. Oh my gosh, I can't even talk. I mean, it's so good because I just kind of, you just keep eating. It's so amazing. Thank you for bringing that in. Not only is it amazing, crunchy tortilla. I typically don't like corn tortillas. I really don't. It's just. But that's but with the it's birria, cooked. The birria is good. It's cooked. It's crispy. It's amazing.
Kind of puffy.
It is amazing.
And yes. Yeah. But I'm your host, Wesley Source, and we will be right back after this short break and with more from El Taco Rustico. And thank you to our amazing sponsors. That's Kiki Rogers of Country Financial Insurance, Vero Premium Beef, Novus Vida, Mafia Kitchen, your financial guy, Cody Peck, Network Outdoors, Local First Arizona, Levity Wellness Center, and Cirrus Visual. Stay tasty, Tucson. This is what...
It's those shrimp taco things. Did you try the shrimp taco with anyone?
The shrimp tacos are yours.
Oh my god!
So I don't good. Do shrimp. That's okay though, because the BDS.
You tried? I had it, yeah. I want to try the view.
So after this break, do you source your tortillas locally?
I when I start my business, I start making my own tortillas.
Yes. Okay. No, I would like to try.
Please come over.
And
you got, you can fix them on the beef.
Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, I get all my tortillas and with Camacho tortilla.
Mm-hmm.
And someone's coming from Nogales.
Okay.
From Hermosillo.
Those yes.
Are made.
Okay.
Actually, the little flour tortillas, and the big ones come from Phoenix.
Mm.
The burro tortillas. It's a good tortilla place, and the tortillas are delicious. I use those tortillas for almost 12 years.
Fair enough. And what about the salsa?
Those salsas are like the green salsa. I stole from this taco place when I was like 16 years old.
Did you get any?
No.
Steal a bite from mom.
Take this shrimp one. It's ready to go.
Oh, you go for it. You enjoy.
Seriously.
You enjoy.
Come on now.
Go for it. I'll steal a bite of her.
Wesley Soars on 1030 The Voice.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. I got love in my tummy and I feel like I'm loving.
Welcome back to the Tucson Tasty Show. I'm your host, Wesley Soars, and we're having a great conversation, learning about local legend. I think I'm going to be a regular after trying that taco. It's so amazing. Thank you for sharing that with us. Juan from El Taco Rustico.
Taco Rustico.
Rustico. And we were talking about where you get your, because one of the things that I found out about the chef community is everybody seems to really like to support the local. And mm-hmm. So if you're not buying, something from somebody, you know, somebody that can get it for you or you're making it yourself. Tell us a little bit about some of your connections in the chef community and where you're kind of sourcing some of your products from.
Well, basically, like I say, I work a lot for a long time in the South Side.
Mm-hmm.
And for being honest, I buy most of my stuff in the local places in the South Side. One of these is this guy is he started time ago and with a food truck, and he decided to make this meat market. It's a Camacho Carniceria.
On 6th.
And 6. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it's a really good provider.
He's my neighbor in Saguarita by Fernando.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So, and the tortillas, they provide me the tortillas, they provide me the meat for everything, almost everything. And sometimes I get my things from meat, city meats, no, the merits.
Merit, yes.
And they're really good.
Yeah, and that's a source for the Vera Earl premium beef as well. Merit actually does source some of their beef through Vera Earl premium beef.
Yeah, I know that.
Yep.
I remember that. Awesome. And some tortillas coming from Mexico, other ones from Phoenix. We need a really good source to get the or stuff because we need got it every day,
Right. That's a lot of tortillas to go through. Yeah. Absolutely. And one of the things I really like about those tortillas is with when you're cooking them or when you're cooking them, they're not hard. They don't become hard because typically with the corn tortillas, you cook them up a little bit, and if you don't eat them, they're really they do get hard, and then they're fluffy. So you get that, and I would let you explain, Jorge, but your mouth is full of food.
That fluffiness is really important. It provides this like crunchiness that's different because it's a soft crunchiness, which is kind of weird.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
but it's delicious, man. It's really good.
You had a question, Cody, before we started.
Yes, Juan, for someone who's coming to visit your restaurants for the first time, what dish are you recommending them come in and try?
You know, it's a good question, but the quesadillas get recommended by itself because they have a line to the door, mm-hmm. and mostly like 75% of the line, they We want quesadillas, quesadillas. So when they, somebody don't know what it is, I want quesadillas because it's what everybody wants.
Yeah, it's a big thing.
Right, yeah. Now.
Yep.
Fair enough.
And if we wanted to go to you to try some of your goat and lamb options, what do you recommend on that side?
The lamb can be good in a taco and like this. We do gorditas, you know, the mm-hmm. corn pockets.
Yeah.
And those are delicious with the lamb and goat.
We love cooking lamb in our house, but we do Greek style lamb. So, you know, it's usually a lamb leg and we're putting a whole bunch of garlic cloves whole and then we rotisserie it. And that's really good. But I want to come. I'm going to be at your restaurant. We're gonna set up some time after the show to come down and really, you know, get a good feel for that.
Well, you gotta film an episode there, man.
Of course, we gotta film an episode there,
and
for the TV show.
And I think you also gotta do a little mini documentary on his.
Oh, you
on his life.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
This is an amazing story.
It really sounds like we have to, we have to go and do research and really try.
Really try? Nah, we just need an iPhone.
You have to take us through a tour through your life and take us to all the places that you've tried or you cooked and all the different places that you tried. I think that would be an amazing episode.
I completely obsessed with the Brazilian steakhouses. I completely love Brazilian and Argentina.
Yes.
Argentina's.
What's that place called? Churrasco?
Yes.
Right?
Yep. Brazilian steakhouse. Yeah. That's over by.
I know the good
places. The Tucson Mall.
So
he knows the good places.
I went to
top secret good places. All right.
The one I love is in Scottsdale. Fogo de Chá, that's the best one.
Yeah,
yeah.
I see the owner of the Churrasco, that was a manager over there, and he copied all the concept and bring it to Tucson. But it's not even half good like the one. It's expensive, but it's good.
Fair enough. Well, we'll have to go figure that one out too. You had a question, Andrew?
How much meat do you go through a week?
Well, just for the birria, it can be like probably like 700 pounds.
Wow.
But I use carne asada. I do other red chili beef. I do...
That's a lot of cows.
We cook.
So just the birria.
I can cook probably 1,000 pounds a week.
That's awesome.
All included.
And you sell out. That's even better.
Mm-hmm. It's always... And that place only can fit 43 seats. And the people love to get there, eat inside. Place full of people, line out to the door, waiting for to go orders.
Mm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's so wonderful, man.
So with the last 2 minutes that we have left for the show, I wanted to ask if are you in for the Tucson Tasty Show Challenge? Are you ready to try some hot sauce? All right. I have to just pass it to you. Here's a chip.
Now we do have a question for you while you eat this. Make it even harder for you. So Juan, what is the one thing in your kitchen you recommend everyone else to keep in their kitchen at all times when it comes to cooking?
Like a food item?
Like a food item, a seasoning, anything like that.
And you don't really need a lot of that, by the way. Right. Just a little bit.
Yes, I hear you.
What's the one thing you need in your kitchen?
While cooking or to cook with?
To cook with, you know, cook with. Well, if you're going to keep it in your kitchen all the time, you know, we had that with Danny and he was, what was he into? He had garlic and ginger. He mm-hmm. loved ginger. Mm-hmm. So.
Well, I say the tortillas.
Tortillas is the one thing. All right, I'm writing that down. Tortillas.
You have ginger and tortillas so far.
Ginger.
Because if I don't have tortillas, I don't have a business.
And tortillas. All right, go ahead and cheers up, gentlemen, and everybody's earnings ticket or their stickers today. If you want your sticker, you can reach out to us on our website, and we'll set something up. We'll come out to see you. And this is the Pepper X hot sauce. What do you think?
It's hot.
It's hot.
I think we should do it at the beginning.
Well, thank you. Thank you for joining us today on the Tucson Tasty Show. We'll see you next week and every week. And we have an amazing guest, Seared, the owners of Seared Living, the meeting room. Thank you to our special guests and sponsors. That's Chef Juan, Jorge Ruiz, Cody Peck, Andrew of Vera Oral Premium Beef. Thank you to Kiki Rogers of Country Financial Insurance, Vera Oral Premium Beef. Novus Vita, Mafia Kitchen, your financial guy, Cody Peck, Network Outdoors, Local First Arizona, Levity Wellness Center, and Cirrus Visual. I'm your host and Wesley Source, and stay tasty, Tucson.
The one constant in life is change. Throughout our lives, we will go down roads that we never imagined, and we need to be prepared for whatever comes our way. Want to own your future? Contact Country Financial Representative Kiki Rogers. Kiki Rogers can help.
The spiciness is too much to you taste the flavor of the salsa.
It's not overwhelming, or it is overwhelming? I don't think it's overwhelming. That's what I really like about it. You get that very good flavor, and then it builds up on you, right?
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
What do you think, Andrew?
It's got a good taste.
You survived?
Yeah.
All right.
Muchísimo gusto. Historia, señor.
Yeah, I recommend some of that that beef. A spoonful of that will take care of it.
Please try the beef.
All right. See you next week.